lesson for you today. Something that has been pivotal in my awareness has been acknowledging and understanding the pain body. So we all know what our ego is, and anyone that follows Eckhart will know this principle of the pain body. But we all know the ego. The ego is the part of us that is quite fearful. It's always working for self-preservation as opposed to oneness and unity. But a part of the ego, which is separate and it's a part of it once we attach to it, is something called the pain body. And the pain body is a collective energy field that we store within and around us that holds on to stories from the past and experiences of trauma. So girls are really good, women are really good at holding on to the pain body. So fellas will notice that a woman can sit there and say to you, you know, in an argument, if 5 years ago you said this exact same thing and you were wearing this and you smelt like that and we were standing here, and we remember all the details of this argument because it is stored inside our pain body. It's almost like a memory center for anything bad that goes on. And the thing about a pain body is it feeds off more pain. So if we've had quite a traumatic childhood, what you'll find is people that have had quite a traumatic childhood will continue to have quite a lot of trauma unless they do work on themselves, a lot of healing work on themselves throughout their life, because they've established a pain body from a very young age, and the pain body needs more pain for it to thrive. So it will continually find situations so it can feed itself with more pain. So you'll find yourself always in those traumatic or dramatic experiences throughout your life. The pain body was something that I really acknowledged when I went through my depression. So I just wanted to share it with you today to have that on your radar, particularly when you are in conflict with somebody else. Your pain body is what is creating that argument. Your soul, your true self, doesn't argue, it doesn't understand conflict, it only knows compassion and love. So the second you engage with someone, you're coming from your ego and your pain body. You're allowing the pain that you're experiencing from the past usually come up and allow it to express itself through this new scenario. So just remember, when you feel that feeling come up, the emotions, that all you need to do is acknowledge it. Acknowledge that this is separate to you, it's a part of your pain body, something that we all have, but we need to master, and understand that you don't need to attach to it. So taking a couple of beautiful deep breaths, separating yourself from the situation that you're in at that point in time. One thing you really don't want to do when you're in conflict is point out to somebody that this is their pain body. That is the worst thing that you could do, because when you're in your pain body is not going to acknowledge that it's a pain body. It is going to fire up and create more drama. So please don't ever point that out to someone. The best thing you can do when you can see someone really going into their pain body is just give them love, because the pain body doesn't feed off love, it feeds off pain. So if you give them love, it helps them calm their farm, and then you can come from a really loving and compassionate place and have still a conversation where you might not agree with each other. It's not about, you know, becoming a doormat. It just means you're going to calm them down. So you're actually talking and communicating with the person. You're not communicating with their crazy pain body. And then you'll find that you'll resolve the conflict or the differences in opinion a lot easier this way, or at least acknowledge that you're different. You don't have to always agree with each other in a loving way. So just remember that, acknowledge yourself whenever you feel those emotions coming up. Acknowledge that it's not you, it's your pain body from the past. And remember, if you heal, you continually heal stories and wounds that you've had in your life, you will be able to have a better grip over your pain body and live a more beautiful life. This is one of the tools that we go through in Heal Your Heart, which is on March 1st from 7 till 9 p.m. It's one of my favorite workshops that we do, because it was something that was detrimental. It was imperative. It was so important for me pushing through my years in depression, was releasing the stories that I'd created from past trauma. And I love sharing this knowledge with everybody that needs it. And if you have a heart, if you've lived a life, if you're a human being, you need it. So hopefully I'll see you there. And if not, just remember, work on your pain body by understanding that that is what is being reactive in any heated moment that you have. Have a beautiful day.